Making games is fun, a multifaceted creative exercise that involves game programming and logic, graphics design, characters and scenery, sound and music, and much more. And if you really want other people to play your game, you will have to think about distribution strategies and maybe even marketing. So in today's video, I will cover the different ways you can distribute your game made in Python using Pygame-CE. Not necessarily how to sell it, I'm not very experienced in that, but rather how to package your game so other people can access it and play it. I won't talk about distribution platforms themselves, since each has its own complexities, fees and bureaucracy. But to use any of them, you will need to package your game in one way or another. So, the first method is the simplest, at least for you, where you just bundle the source code, your Python scripts, and the assets used in the project and make them available to the player, leaving them to figure out how to run it. The problem here is platform and environment differences. The player may have a different version of Python installed, or not have Python installed at all, or may be missing the correct versions of libraries your game uses, making the experience frustrating. One way to reduce this issue is to include a requirements.txt file with your code, listing the necessary library versions and Python version so the player can replicate the exact environment. But let's be honest, unless someone already has some programming knowledge, this is just too complex for an average player who just wants to play. The second method is creating an executable file, which basically bundles Python itself, the libraries, your scripts and assets into a single file or folder that you can share. This method works great if the player uses the same platform as you. For example, if you are on Windows, and so are they. But things get tricky if you are on macOS or Linux and want to create an executable file for Windows or vice versa. One option is to use virtual machines or build the executables on another physical machine. But that's not very practical because you'd need to manage multiple machines, environments, and maintain several different executables. The same goes for Android or iOS. You need a compatible environment to generate apps for each. You can generate Pygame apps for Android on Linux, but it doesn't work as well for iOS. So the third method and the focus of this video is creating web apps, which work on any device or system with a modern browser, including Android and iOS. They even support touchscreen, accelerometer, gyroscope and joystick controls. All this is possible with Pygbag, and it's relatively easy. I have already made videos on my channel about creating web games and converting existing projects for the web, and it works well. But what's the catch? There are a few. Here are the three main limitations. Performance takes a noticeable hit in the web version. Second one is that not all Python libraries work on the web. Pure Python ones usually work fine. It might require you to swap or remove some features libraries from your game. The third one is that your game needs to follow some specific rules. This isn't a problem if you create your game with that in mind from the start, but it's a bit annoying for conversions. Now that you know what Pygbag is, what it does and its limitations, you are ready to make your first game with Pygbag and Pygame. So let's start with an example. Your main script must be called main.py. If Pygbag cannot find it, it will return an error. At the top of the main file, use a pep723 block to list any libraries that you will import. You don't need to list standard libraries like random, math or even Pygame, but it doesn't hurt. This lets Pygbag download them automatically the first time the game runs. Then, you continue the script normally. Import libraries like Pygame, async.io and in this example NumPy. Since we are going to use the module Pygame surf array, we also need to import it explicitly. Your main function must be defined as async. Inside it, initialize Pygame, set up fonts, define the screen resolution, set up a clock, and start the game loop. For this example, in the loop, we will call clock.tick to get the frame delta, handle Pygame events, and exit the loop if needed. use NumPy to create a random frame and turn it into a surface to show it on the screen. Draw a circle at the mouse position. Display the current FPS. Also update the display with Pygame display.flip or update. And very important, include a wait async io.sleep 0. Without it, your game won't run in the browser. Finally, call the main function with async io.run to start the game. You can test the script on desktop first. If it works fine, then run python-m pygbag and the path to your game folder. Then open a browser and go to localhost 8000 and click anywhere inside the tab when you see they're ready to start. If it goes well, it should look the same as the desktop version, though it may appear blurry due to automatic scaling. I will show how to fix it soon. If the screen is black after ready to start, add hashtag debug to the URL localhost 8000 hashtag debug to see the error messages in the terminal. For your games, you will usually want to use images, fonts, and sounds. So here are some simple rules. Keep assets in the same folder as your main.py or in a subfolder. Use forward slashes and not backslashes, like Windows traditionally uses. Avoid special characters and be careful with case sensitivity. For sounds, use awk instead of mp3 or wav, which are not supported. Prefer png or jpg over heavy formats like bmp. Also, load all your assets in the beginning of the game in the main.py. Loading them mid-game or in other scripts can cause issues. To save progress, high scores, and so on, you will need to use JavaScript's local storage, which only works in the browser. So you must detect if a game is running in the browser or on the desktop. Use import sys. If sys platform is mscripten or WASI, then it's web. If not, then it's desktop. To access local storage from platform import window, then use window.localStorageSetItem with key and value for storing information and window.localStorageGetItem and the key for retrieving the information. To fix blurry image, you can use window.canvas.style.imageRendering equal to pixelated. Web controls work like on desktop. Joysticks are supported, though not all of them. For me, the Steam Deck built-in controls were not recognized. For phones, tablets, you will need to support touch or motion sensors. A single finger tap works just like a left mouse click. Pygame supports multi-touch. You can distinguish fingers and track movement. But you may need to write your own logic for detecting gestures like swipes and others. JavaScript and window.eval to set up gyro accelerometer controls. It only works on Android with Chromium-based browsers. And now some performance tips. Use low resolutions. Browsers scale it automatically. Avoid alpha transparency and prefer color key, which are way more efficient on the web. Pre-render whenever possible. For example, if you are using tile maps, you can render the entire map and only re-render things that changed on the fly. Also target higher FPS on desktop, 2 to 3 times the web target. So now that we have the basics covered, we can publish the game. To publish on itch.io, zip the web folder inside build and mark this file will be played on the browser. Another great option are progressive web apps, PWAs, that can be installed on devices like real apps. To create one, put the web folder contents in a GitHub repo. Enable GitHub pages in the repo settings, pages section, selecting the master branch. Your game will then be available on your username.github.io/repository-name. To make it into a PWA, create a manifest.json with app name, short name, which will be displayed under the app icon, start URL with the repo name /index.html. An icon, which Pygbag provides one, but you can use your one instead. Then add this line to the head in the index.html. Once done, you will see an install option in Chrome's address bar on desktop, or the option will appear when you first open it on Chrome for Android. If it doesn't, you can also go to the options and add it to the start screen, which will show an option for installation. It works similarly in Firefox Android. Unfortunately, this did not work on iOS. Maybe I need to change something on the manifest. To publish to the Play Store, use pwabuilder.com. Enter your game URL and it will check everything and give you packaging options, including signed builds for Play Store with details for future signage, or you can choose other Android and sign it manually. And that's it. I hope this guide helps you create Python apps for different platforms using Pygame-CE and Pygbag. If you have questions, I will leave links to the documentations and the Pygame Discord server. Feel free to leave a comment. If I can help, I will try, but it's hard to do it without the actual error messages and source code. Thanks for watching, and until the next time.